It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain Market Update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management. The global stock markets rose once again this week after Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell announced that the Fed would cut interest rates for a second time this year. Federal funds rate, which controls the cost of mortgages, credit cards, and all other borrowing, will now hover around 1.75% and 2%. Now, this is just another stimulus to add to our list of economic stimulus from last week's comment, and great news for an already booming economy. U.S. home construction surged in August to the fastest pace since 2007. Residential starts climbed 12.3% and topped all estimates. And permits, a proxy for future construction, also increased to a 12% high. Now, low mortgage rates and a solid labor market help drive these gains and will only get stronger with the latest rate cut by the Fed. Now, what didn't make headlines after the Fed cut interest rates this week was the yield curve. And that's because the global yield curve, not just the U.S., but other countries like Germany, United Kingdom, and Japan, morphed from slightly inverted 3 weeks ago when every headline screamed recession to slightly positive. And if it continues to be positively sloped, this is, of course, bullish for the global stock markets. As we stated several times, fears of an imminent recession based on the yield curve were overblown and nothing more than market noise. Nonetheless, it gave the financial propaganda channels plenty of opportunities to create fear and sell newsletters. News of the yield curve was so pervasive that it led me to ask you in my August comment, is it possible that there's anyone left in the world who doesn't know that the yield curve inverts prior to a recession? I guess legendary investor Bernard Baruch summed it up best when he said, something that everyone knows isn't worth knowing. And that was the case in August when the market decline was not the end of a bull market or the first ending of a bear market. Nothing more than a short-term correction in an ongoing secular bull market. It came and went fast, and if you blinked, you may have missed it. So for now, continue to ignore the noise, ignore the collective thinking of the financial ministers of propaganda, stay invested, and enjoy the new highs on your portfolio. Now, if you're sitting there wondering, do I have a portfolio appropriate to my goals, appropriate to my family's risk tolerance? Well, why sit there and wonder when you can know? Give us a call or text, 844-752-6692. That's 844-752-6692. This is Bob Payne, and I'm the Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management.